Good morning and welcome to a new QuickEdit video. This time I want to show you the post-processing for a nice foggy morning landscape picture. So let's first just check out the before and after images. I want to start the editing by going to the Lens Correction tab and activate those two settings. Then I want to continue with a bit of color grading. As you can see, this image has a slight green color cast, which looks kind of ugly. To start fixing that, I start by going to the calibration tab all the way down in Lightroom, and then I am adjusting the red, green and blue primary hues. Let's see, I'm going to remove some hue from the red primary. Then I'm adding some to the green ones. And then again, I'm removing some from the blue primary hues. And you can see in the before and after the green color cast got a little bit better. Okay, then I want to continue with editing. Therefore, I'm going all the way back to the top. I already chose a profile for which I'm going with the Adobe Color profile. This one just adds some more saturation and contrast to the image. Next thing I want to do is adjust the white balance. I think I need to cool this image down a little bit. So I'm reducing the temperature. And I also want to add some tint to give it a little bit of a magenta color cast. And as you can see, the green color cast is almost gone. Good, then I want to reduce the highlights. And I'm increasing the shadows. And I think I also increase the clarity a bit, as well as the vibrance. And that was it for the basic editing. Now I want to go on with the local adjustments. Let's first start with the gradiated filters. As you can see, I have already applied three of those. The first one being just for the sky part of this image. And basically I want to further reduce the exposure here, so I'm dropping that. And I guess I want to warm up the sky a little bit, so I'm increasing the temperature here. Okay, that's it for the first gradiated filter. The next one is just for the foreground part of this image. I want to bring back some highlights, so I'm increasing them. And I think I could also add some clarity, just to have some more structure in the foreground. Okay, that looks good. Then the third gradiated filter is basically for the middle part of this image. And here I want to increase the whites. And I also increase the clarity a little bit further. Also, I don't like how the clarity changes the foreground in this case, so I'm going to erase that part of this gradiated filter. Therefore, I'm clicking on brush and then erase. I think I'm taking a nice big brush and reduce the flow a little bit. And then I'm just brushing over the foreground. Okay, that looks way better. Good, then I want to continue with the radial filters. Again, I have applied several of those throughout the image. First, I want to work on the middle part of this one. Basically, I want to bring in some more contrast in this foggy area. So first, I'm reducing the blacks. As you can see, this brings out those trees in the haze. Then I want to further increase the clarity. And then I want to reduce the saturation, because it's kind of oversaturated in there. I think I need to down the clarity again a little bit and maybe add some noise reduction as well. Then the next radial filter. This one is basically to add some vignetting to my image. Therefore, I am reducing the exposure a little bit. Now with the two radial filters left, I want to fake some kind of glow slash sun effect. Therefore, I first want to adjust the bigger one of those two. For this one, I'm increasing the whites quite a lot, as well as the blacks, which will add a bit of glow. And then I also need to adjust the temperature. And then the second radial filter is to further increase this bright area. Again, I'm increasing the whites and the blacks. Here I just want to decrease the clarity to make this area a little bit blurry. And that's already it for the local adjustments. Next step is continuing with the color grading. First, I really want to get rid of most of the colors, so I'm reducing green and aqua and blue all the way down. And I think I also need to down the purple color saturation. And then I want to add some saturation to the orange color tones, something like this. And then continue with the split toning. For the highlights, I obviously want to have a nice warm color. And I also want to increase the strength. And for the shadows, I want to have a nice blue color tone. And in this case, I want to reduce the strength. And I also need to touch the balance a little bit, just so the highlights won't be too affected by this change. But instead the shadows will come out stronger after the split toning. Okay, and obviously I'm going to sharpen this image quite a lot. And because I did quite a lot of editing, which automatically increases the noise, I'm also applying some noise reduction. Alright, that's it for the Lightroom part. I'm now switching over to Photoshop to finish this image. So I don't think there's much left to do, but first I want to get rid of a sensor spot which I just noticed. So as you can see, this little spot right here. Therefore I'm just using the healing brush and remove it real quick. Next I want to go through the Nick Collection plugin to see if there are any useful effects. And I think first I'm going with the detail extractor, just to bring out some details in the foggy area of this image. So I first need to adjust this filter. I think that looks good. Obviously it's way too strong to be applied over the whole image, so I need to mask out certain areas. I'm going to apply a layer mask on this detail extractor layer and fill this layer mask with a black color. Then I'm choosing a white brush and brush it in where I want this effect to be. Let's see, I want to have it over this tree. And maybe a little bit on the left side. Okay, I think that looks really nice. Okay, looking at the histogram, this image is kind of a bit too dark. I want to change that by applying a levels adjustment layer. And now I'm bringing this highlight pin a little bit down just to increase the highlights. And I think I mask out this dark wood area and maybe the foreground as well. Okay, then I want to merge those two layers and then I want to apply just a little bit more glow. So I'm creating a new layer, set the blending mode to soft light. Then I'm using the color picker to pick a color from this sun area. Then I'm taking the brush tool with a nice big and soft brush and just paint over this area once. Maybe a little bit too farther down. Again, let's place it a little bit above the tree line and maybe decrease the saturation. Doesn't work this way. And then let's change the opacity. Alright, I think that looks pretty good. I guess I stop with the editing at this point because otherwise it would be too much. So thank you very much for watching this video, and if you'd like to see more content like this, then please feel free to subscribe to my channel.